You're watching the USA Network.
Symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Down in front goes Mr. Wonderful, nice arm drag, caught him coming in, and another one. Morocco got outsmarted.
I don't think so. Look at how fast.
Well, that's going to be a barn burner in tag team action this week. Our feature bout, it's going to be Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, teaming up with Scott McGee, outstanding superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation. That tandem to go against Don Morocco and Moondog Spot. Hi again, everyone. This is Gene Okerlund back in the World Wrestling Federation Sports Control Center. And again, welcome to All American Wrestling. Speaking of tag team bouts, Tito Santana this week to team up with Pedro Morales, where the two of them go head-to-head with the Gladiator and Brian McKnee. You're going to be seeing highlights from a recent Saturday night's main event, Jake the Snake Roberts and Ricky Steamboat. Hercules Hernandez to face, I don't know, is that Henry Morgan or...
Terry Morgan,
I'm sorry. In addition, Tiger Chung Lee squares off against Don Koloff. That and a special telephone call after this. Don't go away.
Super 2 Plus leaves a lubricant behind with each stroke. Super 2 Plus, every stroke's as comfortable as the first.
I need to get, you better get, gotta get sick.
Every late night morning I put on my blue. Levi's button fly, 501 blue. Well, they shrink down to fit you and only you, baby. Button fly, I don't it make you wanna hoo. That's the truth. Levi's 501 blue.
Absorbing Junior invites all hard-working Americans to rub it in.
Rub it in.
Absorbing Junior, the big rub it in solution for sore aching muscles. With deep penetrating action that gets under your skin fast for soothing relief.
Put it on my back, my sack will really act.
Absorbing Junior.
Rub it in, rub it in.
So what do you do to relax?
Look for trouble.
Society is breeding a new kind of criminal.
Captain, look, I don't want to be a hero. I just want to get involved, all right?
It's also breeding a new kind of cop.
You're a disease, and I'm the cure.
Stallone is Cobra. Rated R. Opens Memorial Day weekend.
This is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my left, from Culebra, Puerto Rico, weighing 240 pounds, Pedro Morales. His partner from Tacuba, Mexico, at 244 pounds, Tito Santana. Their opponent, from Hamilton, Ontario, at 232 pounds, Brian McKnee. His partner from parts unknown, weighing 246 pounds, the Gladiator.
Interesting tag team combination. Pedro Morales, former Mr. Everything here in the World Wrestling Federation, former world champion, former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, former co-holder of just about everything. That you
oh, yes, he does have credentials. Jack of all trade, master of none.
Well, how could you possibly say that, Adrian? My God.
We'll see.
Two Intercontinental, former Intercontinental Champions teaming up should make for a tremendous, tremendous tag team combination.
Oh, most definitely. I have to admit that Mr. Santana and Mr. Morales do have some credentials. They're agile, they know the ropes, they know the holds, and plus that, they're not jealous of each other. That's what ruins tag teams.
Well, you ought to know, because you were once part of the East-West connection with Jesse the Body Ventura, incidentally, who you're filling in for while he makes his movie debut.
Yes.
Isn't it exciting? Puerto Vallarta, a place that you might like to be.
Nothing's better than San Francisco or New York City.
I guess not. Morales holding down the Gladiator.
Right now, Mr. Monsoon, if he knew the ropes, he'd be bouncing his chin right in the man's solar plexus.
Well, obviously, two ring veterans in there right now, the Gladiator, Pedro Morales. Of course, the experience edge definitely has to go to former Mr. Everything, Pedro Morales. But the Gladiator with an arm ringer, Morales reverses it immediately.
Oh, it looks like the Gladiator's been around the block in this business too, Mr. Monsoon.
He certainly has, as well as you've been around the block, through the block, and in and out of the closet as well.
My, don't we know everything?
Yes. Uh-oh, in for the ride. Look out, big backdrop. Lucky for him, he cushioned that blow a little bit.
Yes, I know he tried to go on his feet, but he isn't as agile as the Adonis one.
How agile can you maintain, Adrian, as long as you keep getting heavier and heavier? You have to be.
I have dropped 10 pounds.
You dropped it where? You found it somewhere, I guess, because you are the biggest right now I've ever seen you in your entire career.
Well, this is a surprise for everyone, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so. Santana in there now. Look out. Nice shoulder block. Sends the Gladiator down. Watch that toehold. Beauty. Nice maneuver by the Gladiator.
It was the timing of it. They knew just where to hit the man at the right part of the joint. That's what brings the man down. And also, you can injure a knee very, very viciously.
Let me ask you this, Adrian, while I've got you here for all our wrestling fans out there. On a number of occasions, I've heard your sleeper hold called 15 different things. What do you call it?
There was Good Night Irene. Now it has to be the adorable squeeze.
The adorable squeeze. Good. Look at this, Morales. Trapped in the wrong part
good
of
the tag team. Good tag team.
Brian McPhee in there now.
Come on, lay him in, Jack.
Front face lock now by young Brian. Morales here, he's got a very short fuse. Look out. Oh, beautiful move.
I have to admit, Monsoon, that was a tremendous move, and he did tag out because the punishment was too much for Mr. Morales at that time.
Well, that's what tag team.
Look at Tito. Look at Tito. Has to go to punch him.
Another back chop. Oh, here comes the Gladiator. Got fed with a nice forearm shot by former Intercontinental Champion.
What a showboat Mr. Chico is.
It's Tito, not Chico.
Oh, excuse me. Chico.
Look out. Oh. Talk about southpaw shots. You just saw one right there. Watch out.
He's going to the inside deckbreaker.
Oh, beauty.
It was. I have to admit, it was.
Well executed.
I think this is it.
It's all over. Good night, Irene. Oh, sorry, I lost my head. I didn't mean to say that.
Just sort of trying to be a social climber.
Tremendous victory by that team right there. Two former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champions, Tito Santana, Pedro Morales. Let's go up and get the official word.
The winners of this bout, the team of Tito Santana and Pedro Morales.
Let me ask you this, Adrian. Do you intend to make a trip down to Puerto Vallarta to visit Jesse while he's making this movie down there? Is that in your repertoire? Is that in your itinerary?
Oh, come on, stop it.
Let's go back and take a look here. Young Brian McKnee gets rammed in. Wow, big left hand right to the lower solar plex. And now Morales in perfect position to set him up. Big backbreaker coming up right here. He's got this down to a science. Look at this shot. Wow. You could count to 100. We have with us right now Tito Santana, Pedro Morales. Congratulations, gentlemen, on your tremendous victory, tremendous tag team competition, and you're going to be seeing plenty of it here in the World Wrestling
Federation. You sure are. Thank you very much. You know, it's always great to team up with Pedro.
Pedro has had every belt in the WWF, and I enjoy teaming up with him and getting advice from him.
Well, great. We expect to see great things from you two in the future. We'd like to see you in there with the likes of Big John Studd and maybe King Kong.
We're ready for any kind of action.
Once again, you know that I'm ready, and with Tito in my corner, we are ready for anything.
Thank you very much.
I know, Pedro, you're ready for any kind of action. Very good. Tito Santana, Pedro Morales, certainly another great tag team that is present here at the World Wrestling Federation. By the way, later on here at All American Wrestling, you're going to be seeing the Flower Shop, which is hosted by adorable Adrian Adonis. His manager, of course, Jimmy Hart, will be there. This week's special guest will be the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Stay tuned for that. More exciting action coming up, but right now, let's bring you up to date with the World Wrestling Federation on tour.
It's the World Wrestling Federation on tour, coming to these great areas and facilities with action. Sunday, May 25th, Uniondale, Long Island, New York, Nassau Coliseum, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff on the bill in Uniondale. Saturday, May 24th, Phoenix, Arizona, Veterans Memorial Coliseum. You'll see the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat in Phoenix. Saturday, May 24th, Boston, Massachusetts, Boston Garden, Hulk Hogan with a title defense in Boston. Friday, May 23rd, Denver, Colorado, Denver Coliseum, the Magnificent Morocco seeing action in Denver. Friday, May 23rd, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh Civic Arena, King Kong Bundy on the card in Pittsburgh. Thursday, May 22nd, Sacramento, California, Arco Arena, the Funston manager Jimmy Hart in action in Sacramento. Thursday, May 22nd, Cincinnati, Ohio, the Riverfront Coliseum, the British Bulldog and Tito Santana on the card. It's the World Wrestling Federation. Be a part of it when it comes to your area.
What's that?
One of those new hostess pudding pies. What's up?
Maybe a little.
Plain pudding never tasted this good.
Mmm.
There's chocolatey icing on top.
Uh-huh.
Great crust. And tons of creamy real vanilla pudding inside.
What are you doing?
New hostess pudding pies. Plain pudding just can't taste this good.
You ate the whole thing. Saved you some.
Important medical news for sufferers of acid indigestion. Now, a new survey has revealed that doctors prefer the relief formula in Rolaids over the formula in Tums. Rolaids antacid medicine first consumes all the acid required to bring millions 100% relief, and then keeps on working to help keep your stomach trouble-free. Treat the pain and burn of excess stomach acid with serious medicine. Remember, doctors prefer the relief formula in Rolaids over the formula in Tums.
Now is your last chance to get preseason prices from VIP Marine and over 40 different Bayliner boats, because after May 15th, it'll be over. Summer prices will be here. Prices will never be lower. 1600 Capri Bow Rider, 95 a month. 1950 Capri Bow Rider, 134 a month. 2450 Sierra Designer Sunbridge, only 232 per month. And the 2850 Contessa Sunbridge, only 395 a month. VIP Marine, Redwood City Marina, Oakland, and San Jose.
Get me Brzezinski. Brzezinski, I need four copiers. Copiers that make crisp, clear, edge-to-edge copies.
Yes, sir.
A copier that enlarges and reduces with three colors and one-touch color change.
Yes, sir.
And buy these copiers from an authorized dealer with several area locations and excellent service.
Yes, sir.
When demands are this high, there's only one name to remember.
Hello, AA Office Equipment and Furniture Company.
Because AA Office Equipment and Furniture means copiers, too.
This is Lord Alfred Hayes with a special update. Providence, Rhode Island, Saturday night main event. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat matched against Jake the Snake Roberts. Ricky claimed, placing the snake on an opponent is an insult. I will rid wrestling of Roberts and his snake. Here is that footage.
Jake the Snake Roberts!
In the feet of Jake the Snake Roberts making his way to the ring. And in that bag, ladies and gentlemen, you can bet there are no weasels in there. There's going to be a snake for sure.
Weighing 237 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. I believe he will no doubt defeat Jake the Snake. Look at him slithering underneath the bottom rope.
Let me tell you something, McMahon. I wouldn't worry about weasels. I wouldn't worry about serpents.
I'd worry about that pineapple farmer there. But let's just see how tough the Dragon really is.
Well, we're going to find that out for sure. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, one of the most popular athletes in the World Wrestling Federation today, saying hello. Off the rope now. Ooh, what a clothesline. He didn't even let him in the ring.
He was too interested in waving to the little girls in the crowd to pay attention to business. It's his own fault.
Oh, another clothesline down to the concrete. The match has not even started yet. Out underneath the battle rope. Jed Roberts.
He's signaling for that DDT.
He's not. Oh, no.
Hey, Steamboat, that's using your head.
Oh, my goodness.
I like it.
Steamboat, unconscious. Totally out of it.
I smell something. Is that pineapple juice? What is that you smell?
Roberts. Savage. Ricky Steamboat back into the ring. Steamboat totally out of it. Unconscious. After striking his head.
Oh, he's not going to go into that. Oh, yeah, he is. Oh, yeah, I think Damien's coming out for some air.
No. Oh, he's not going to. God.
I love it.
Oh, God, I can't believe it. Slithering all over Ricky's lead ahead on that snake.
That snake's got to be 175 pounds.
Oh, he's jamming his mouth. I can't believe that. I can't believe it.
I think the Dragon is out.
He
is out.
Oh, he's taking. He's going to choke him. He's going to choke the breath right out of him.
I think the word you're searching for is juice.
Look at that. Jake Snake with a python all over Ricky Steamboat, who's totally unconscious. Look at it, Snake slithering in the back. Oh, yeah.
He's squeezing.
Help me out.
These are the World Wrestling Federation officials. Now, what are they saying?
Oh, yeah, look. Roberts now. Using the snake. Hoping the snake is going to bite one of these officials.
Oh, but that's too. Who's that guy sticking his nose in?
Steamboat, unconscious, was taken from the ring by stretcher only after many officials had demanded that Roberts should leave.
Finally on the outside. There, Jake Roberts with Damien on his way back as we see, unfortunately, Ricky Steamboat still unconscious.
Well, looks like he proved his point. Oh, there's Mrs. Steamboat. Are you upset? Is your pineapple picking husband all laid out? Why don't you go nurse him back to health, lady?
Steamboat, still unconscious, was taken to a nearby locker room with a doctor in attendance and his friend Junkyard Dog at his side.
We let him.
Oh. What happened?
He put the DDT on him. He was out there waving around, man. He got jumping from the back. That's what happened.
Oh, the cement floor. Oh, I remember now. Oh, my God.
Just lay back, man.
Lay back. Oh, no. What happened?
What happened? He jumped from behind and put that DDT on you.
What happened?
He laid that stinking old snake on you, man.
Oh, no. Oh, it's enough to have that. Oh, God, he put that snake on me. Oh, God, let me up. Let me get
him. You need to lay down, man.
My head.
The doctor diagnosed a mild concussion and stated that, with rest, Ricky would be back in action shortly. Jake the Snake has certainly not seen the last of the Dragon.
Well, I don't mind telling you, I happen to be in Providence for Saturday night's main event. In addition to that slight concussion, Steamboat received a knot that had to be the better part of an inch and a half protruding from the forehead, and he was out like a light for a long, long time. Ricky Steamboat has vowed revenge against Jake Roberts. Let's go to more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 225 pounds, Terry Morgan. Now, first, I'd like to introduce the manager, Classy Freddie Blassie. Now, introducing from Florida, weighing 200...
Hercules Hernandez, being admonished by his own manager, the fashion plate, Freddie Blassie, is going to work with a vengeance on Terry Morgan. Gorilla Monsoon hit ringside with Bobby the Brain Heenan, and he is a bad man, Bobby.
That's Hercules.
quick for him outside the ring, but Hercules caught up with him immediately once again. Look at that. He chased him outside, one caught him, now he threw him out again.
Those yellow stripes ought to be up that guy's back.
Very dangerous maneuver with that leap off the apron of the ring by Hercules Hernandez. Nothing down there, but concrete.
Some people like the sound of good music, popcorn. I like the sound of a guy hitting a cement floor.
Oh, look at that. Ramden into the steel railing surrounding our ring here. The barricade. Not faring too well this week here in the World Wrestling Federation. Young Terry Morgan. As he's out there right now with our ringsiders. Look at Blassie. Come on, ref. Don't let him do that.
He's being helpful. He's trying to help the man back in there.
Manager, as you well know, however you don't very often observe, is supposed to keep his hands and any other part of his anatomy off the wrestler.
Yes, but there are times when you can be helpful. That's what Classic Freddy's doing.
Hercules Hernandez, Tampa, Florida, a real powerhouse, the latest find of the fashion plate, Freddy Blassie. Looked like he might have had a little trouble finding him for this match.
Freddy's in control at all times.
Hercules reaching in. Whoa, what a slam. He just drove him down into the canvas. Devastation with that nice elbow drop. Look at the look of contentment on the face of Hercules Hernandez. And quite the opposite of the kisser of young Terry Morgan. And Freddie just thrilled about it.
Kick his ribs in.
Oh, yeah, sure. Did you hear that? Kick his ribs in, he said. Uh-oh, clothesline job done on the top rope by Hercules Hernandez.
You know, a good manager should always be proud of his proteges.
I'm sure you are extremely proud of Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy. Look at this. Hercules. Oh, what an elbow off the second turnbuckle from the inside. Morgan is about out of this match.
Yeah, I don't know what Freddy's done, but I've never seen Hernandez this vicious. I love it. That's a winner in there.
He certainly is a very vicious individual. There's no question about that, but I would like to see him here in the World Wrestling Federation with a little stiffer competition, buddy.
I imagine he would, too.
You know, it's easy to go in there and try to humiliate a youngster who's trying to make a name for himself in the world of professional wrestling like Terry Morgan. And it's quite something else when you get in there with a full-fledged veteran and try to do the same tactics. Suplex coming up. A handful of tights and helped him execute that move.
Look at the eye contact between him and Fred.
Blassie saying now, lay the backbreaker on him. Hernandez reaching back in for that patented backbreaker of his. This one is all over. Come on, Russ, get the youngster out of there. Oh, look at that. That could maim you and permanently end anyone's career, that move right there.
Well, you want to bet he'll be sleeping on his stomach for the next 6 months.
Let's go up and get the official word.
The winner of the match, Hercules Hernandez.
Hercules Hernandez chalking up another victory here. Let's go back and take a look at that patented backbreaker. Once he slaps that on your body, there's no way out.
Pick a man up with one hand.
Just one hand. I watch this little added gesture here right at the end as he drops to his knees, adding further damage. An exciting individual will be back.
Now, wrestling fans, without a doubt, the World Wrestling Federation has some of the greatest wrestlers you will find anywhere, but certainly giving credit where credit is due, the gentleman out of Hamilton, Ontario, Iron Mike Sharp, one of the best conditioned athletes you will find in any sport. But Iron Mike, I know you lay claim to being Canada's greatest athlete. Now, Canada's had some great athletes from Wayne Gretzky to Bobby Hull, Johnny Bright, Wally Moon, the list is endless. First off, why, what gives you the right to lay claim to make that statement?
Because I believe it is the truth. I believe in myself. I believe in the record. And I think I've shown all the people, I've shown the whole wrestling world, that Iron Mike is number one in professional wrestling. He's just not getting the breaks. He's not getting the chances. People are ducking me right and left. And you know why that is? Because they're afraid of the Iron Man.
They're afraid of this big right hand right here, this big arm coming crashing down on their skull. They haven't got the guts to get in there and face me. They haven't got the guts to put their signature on the dotted line. That's what it is. That's what it's all about.
Iron Mike, if I may, speaking of that big right arm, a lot of people in the World Wrestling Federation feel that this arm brace gives you an undue advantage, that by now the arm should certainly
be healed.
That's
not true. That is not true. I have explained this all in the past. I've gone over this thoroughly. This is an old injury that was a sports injury. I have permission to wear this. It's just protection. It has no bearing whatsoever on the outcome of my matches. The reason I am able to knock people out with this big right arm has nothing to do with the leather. It is the strength and the power and the endurance in this arm. And nobody wants to face that fact, but it is the truth. And I'll guarantee you, if some of these top names in the business would just put their name on that dotted line and get in with Iron Mike, I would show some of these people right here. What do you mean? What are you talking about? We're out of time. I have a lot more to say. What are you talking about?
Perhaps anywhere.
The greatest athlete, and you're cutting me off. What's the matter with you, for crying out loud?
Centerfire, automatic water weapon, batteries not included, with up to 30 feet of firing power, an extra clip for reloading, a shoulder strap for moving out. There's also the M16 rifle, the sidekick pistol, the RPG rocket water launcher, the AK Centerfire.
The look, the feel, the sound, so real.
Boy, do I get tired of tall jokes.
How's the weather up there?
But I don't get angry anymore. I open a Sun Country wine cooler instead. You see, Sun Country's a refreshing blend of real fruit juice and premium white wine. It tastes so great, I could ignore all the wisecracks.
Sun Country, say, give me the real juice cooler.
Next time you hear, could you please move? You're blocking the sun. Open a Sun Country. If that doesn't do it, wash them like a grape.
Every late night morning, I put on my blue. Levi's Buttonfly 501 Blue. Well, they shrink down to fit you and only you, baby. Buttonfly, I don't even make you wanna ooh. That's the truth. Levi's 501 Blue.
Now, perfect polished nails in seconds. Lee Press-On Nails in fashion colors. Press-On Color, no messy polish. Press-On Color, no drying time. Press-On Color, no chipping ever. Lee Press-On Nails in fashion colors. Everything you need for longer, polished nails. Lee Super Stick Tabs and 20 Lee Press-On Nails in a variety of sizes. Available in a rainbow array of today's popular colors. So press on. Lee Press-On Nails, now in fashion colors.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Korea, weighing 280 pounds, Tiger Chung Lee. His opponent, from Bulgaria, weighing 240 pounds, Don Kolov.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside, along with special guest this week, one of the premier managers, if not the premier manager, here in the World Wrestling Federation. Welcome to the WWF microphones, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Well, I hope it's going to be everybody's pleasure to listen to my non-biased comments about the evening of wrestling. I mean,
I'm sure they will, Bobby. I'm sure that you're just full of information that you will explode with and enlighten the fans with.
Well, as I've been watching, I've been noticing how you're very one-sided. So I feel it's my job to just enlighten the people to professional wrestling how it should be conducted.
Oh, great. That's terrific news.
You'll enjoy this.
I'm glad to hear that. Looking here at Tiger Chung Lee, the big Korean, master of the martial arts, in there with Don Kolov from Bulgaria. I was in Bulgaria in my amateur wrestling days.
Robert?
Do you like to be called Robert or the brain or the weasel?
Well, my friend, hey, pal, I am not going to sit out here and take this.
Well, I've heard, I've heard you be referred to.
My friends call me Bobby.
Oh, okay, Bobby.
You can call me Mr. Heenan.
Oh, okay. Fine. Whatever turns you on. Koloff with a nice arm bar here on the big Korean, Tiger Chung Lee. Right up into a hammerlock, nicely executed. Another tremendous crowd on hand here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, as this is rapidly becoming one of the meccas for all of professional wrestling. Tiger Chung Lee tying up the Bulgarian, just like a pretzel, nowhere to go. Good place to reach over and grab the ropes, which he does very conveniently.
Kind of a coward's way out, wouldn't you say, Mansu?
Well, there isn't much of a way out for that hole, Bobby.
I'm sure you'd have some way to get out. I know I have a way to get out of it.
Well, you'd probably turn around and poke a finger in the eye or bite the guy on the thigh or something to that effect. I notice you haven't been down in the tights too much of late.
Well, you know, I don't particularly care to get my hands soiled. I'd rather sit back and watch my men, Bundy or Studden, beat the daylights out of somebody rather than do it myself.
Well, you're currently possessing one of the most powerful and awesome teams in all of professional wrestling today in Studden, Bundy. And, of course, I'm sure that you'll be looking to sign some contracts with the name of the newly crowned champions, the British Bulldogs, right on the dotted line, will you not?
Well, I'd love to get their name on the dotted line if those two little miserable limeys can print their names. See, but they got a manager that does all that for them. How would you like to have your whole life and career handled by Captain Louis Albano?
Well, Captain Louis Albano, incidentally, Manager of the Year winner.
Thank you very much.
No, you were not. Lou Albano was.
Well, I'm Manager of the Year.
Well, it may be in your own mind you are, but Captain Louis Albano got the award. Being that the British Bulldogs dethroned Brutus Beefcake and Greg the Hammer Valentine, they are the 16th pair of champions that Captain Lou has brought to the title.
16 of them he had, huh?
16. Look out! Into the corner, nobody home. Don Koloff now going to work on the big Korean. Arm whip in, look out, drop kick. And there goes Tiger Chung Lee onto the concrete floor here in Toronto Maple Leaf Gardens.
I think it's very smart for... I think it was very smart for Tiger Chung Lee to kind of slow things down now.
Well, he didn't go out of his own volition.
No, I said he's slowing him down, and he didn't come right back off that floor and come right back after the man like I would have.
Well, Tiger Chung Lee, a ring veteran, naturally trying to take some of the momentum away from the youngster. But I don't know. I can't see any way, shape, or form that Koloff is going to get by Tiger Chung Lee and use him as any kind of a stepping stone in his career.
Well, he's just another ham and egger as far as I'm concerned. He should maybe stay home, help with the laundry, watch the kids, do yard work.
Tiger Chung Lee with that big forearm shot and another one. Dropped him right to his knees. Uh-oh, starting to unload now with some of that martial arts.
You know, they say Tiger Chung Lee's feet are just as strong as his hands. They're just as hard.
Well, I tend to believe that. Anybody that can walk into the ring without any footwear on just goes beyond me. I don't understand how they can do that. Of course, I know it saves them a lot of money.
Well, I doubt if he's looking at the financial aspect of his wrestling career by not wearing shoes. It's his heritage.
He uses some of those karate kicks and thrust kicks that are certainly more effective without boots on. One count only as Koloff manages to kick out of there rather easily. Tiger Chung Lee starting to unload here. Unfortunately for Don, he's on the receiving end. Understand that, Bobby, why don't you explain to the fans a little bit? I understand you're having some problems with my dear friend Andre the Giant.
Oh, I've never had any problems with Andre the Giant. He's the one that's been having problems with me. None of my members of my family got their haircut. No members of my family were put in the hospital. It was the likes of Andre the Giant, Hulk Hogan. Those people were having trouble.
Well, didn't I understand, or maybe I misunderstood, but I thought I heard you on an international interview saying that you were entering in some litigation with Andre.
Oh, I know what you're talking about now, how he took the coward's way out. He didn't show up. Yes, that's not having trouble with him, because, you see, I'm going to win out in the end. By the time my attorneys get through,
watch out. Pile driver coming up. Oh, good night.
Looks to me like Tiger Chung Lee is wrestling in a walk.
It is over.
Teriyaki'd another one. Yeah, by the time I'm done with Andre the Giant, he'll be a broken and busted man.
Well, that remains to be seen. A lot of guys have made that statement. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
The winner of the match, Tiger Chung Lee.
Tiger Chung Lee got tired of playing with Don Koloff, and here's what happened. Let's go back and take a look at the video replay. Devastating pile driver coming up. How easily he turned him upside down. There's no hope once he gets you in that position, Bobby.
No.
It's only one way, and it's down. Oh, good night.
Well, if you're smart enough and use your brains, you don't let anybody get you like that. Well, I certainly would never be in that position.
That remains to be seen. On to victory, Tiger Chung Lee. Don't go away, wrestling fans. We'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have on the telephone with me right now the manager of the nuclear power plant in Chernobyl in the Soviet Union. Hello? Yes, Gene Okerlund from the World Wrestling Federation. Your name, sir? Yuri Boryanko. Good, Yuri. A few questions I wanted to pose to you this week. Yeah, how are things in Chernobyl? Oh, you're not there. Where? Siberia. Oh, I understand. Real good. Say, I was reading in the USSR today, the forecast does not look good at all for your area. Yes. Cloudy and 4,000 degrees, that's not good at all. No. Say, I've got one for you. What has wings and glows? You've heard it? Chicken Kiev. Real good. Say, I understand the Swedes and Norwegians are a little hot about all of this. I'm sorry to hear that. Sir, it's been a pleasure. Yes, good luck to you. Keep cool. Real good. Oh, mercy. We'll be right back.
Люблю я хорошо пожить, люблю икру черную белужью, музыку Петра Ильича Чайковского. Большой боец!
Не забудь тарелочку горячего борща!
Но больше всего на свете люблю я прохладный освежающий вкус тигром Вайн Кулер.
To understand what people are talking about, try a refreshing Seagram's Wine Cooler.
Ответа в капитализм? Я хочу побольше.
What's that?
One of those new hostess pudding pies. What's up?
Maybe a little.
Plain pudding never tasted this good.
Mmm. There's chocolate icing on top.
Uh-huh.
Great crust. And tons of creamy, real vanilla pudding inside.
What are you doing?
New Hostess pudding pies. Plain pudding just can't taste this good.
You ate the whole thing. Saved you some.
Get me Brzezinski. Brzezinski, I need four copiers. Copiers that make crisp, clear, edge-to-edge copies.
Yes, sir.
A copier that enlarges and reduces with three colors and one-touch color change.
Yes, sir.
And buy these copiers from an authorized dealer with several area locations and excellent service.
Yes, sir.
When demands are this high, there's only one name to remember.
Hello, AA Office Equipment and Furniture Company.
Because AA Office Equipment and Furniture means copiers, too.
Don't fight, fellas. There's plenty of entertainment to go around. All on HBO in May. The start of HBO's summer celebration. With movies like Brewster's Millions and Lady Hawk. Specials from The Music of Minnelli to The Comedy of Mandel. Sports like the live Tyson fight. Exclusive entertainment that makes HBO special.
That good, huh?
More than 100 features a month. Call your cable company now for this great entertainment value. HBO in May. Don't miss the fireworks.
Gotcha.
All right, this coming Wednesday on TNT, a scene on the USA Cable Network. Sweetheart. Oh, I like that. What's your name? Gene, that rings a bell. I'm going to be a special guest host, I guess that'd be it, Lord Alfred Hayes, along with yourself, of this very popular program. Excuse me. There we go. Can we get a shot of this? TNT, we're going to have a ton of special guests. Right now, let's go to the flower shop. Adrian Adonis and Jimmy Hart are there.
And now, here's your host of the flower shop, Adorable Adrian!
Heart of our heart.
Eskimos, aren't we? Oh, well, another edition of the Flower Shop. Isn't it wonderful? Isn't it fab? Isn't it great? After all, the Flower Shop means sweet and smelling things. And boy, do I like sweet things. Jimmy, we had a wonderful time on our ferry boat last week. We just went up and down the river. We ate a lot of fruits, and we had a heck of a time. Well, who is our guest today?
We've got a very, very special guy, Adrian. Listen to me. I'm so excited I can't hardly talk.
And I'll tell you something right now. Randy Macho Man Savage, how are you?
Who's coming who right now? You're coming on everyone's
hello, Liz. My, your lipstick's fab. Who does your makeup?
Well, I do.
I'm jealous.
Jealousy! Jealousy! Don't be jealous. I'm the champion. I am the champion. Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of the world. Hulk Hogan, don't be jealous. Tito Santana, don't be jealous. Just accept things as they are.
Mr. Hogan, I have a feeling that he's going to be like a yo-yo because he's had his ups and he's definitely going to have his downs. Oh, the Flower Shop with Macho and Liz and my friend Jimmy. It's just a wonderful combo right here, and it's a swinging trio. Randy, we've tagged up and we've had a wonderful time, but I just want to close this right now and sing. I love you, and I love you, and I love you, and I'd like to give you, Liz, some flowers. No. For you. You've seen it on the Flower Shop. Good night.
I dig it. Yeah, that's great.
That was interesting. Savage, I bet, wouldn't turn his back on that guy. We recently were in Australia. There's Ricky Steamboat, myself, and a couple of our friends. Here, hold on. I've got another. Oh. Here is, well, this is like the cream of society. Huh? The Frenchman, René Goulet. The golden boy, Arnold Skolin, and you know who. Oh, wait. Yeah, let me turn this. Just friends of ours. All happened in Australia. Let's bring you up to date right now as the World Wrestling Federation tours the country.
The World Wrestling Federation on tour, coming to these great areas and facilities with action. Friday, May 30th, Richmond, Virginia, Richmond Coliseum, the champion Hulk Hogan tops a big card in Richmond. Friday, May 30th, Providence, Rhode Island, Providence Civic Center, Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik on the bill in Providence. Thursday, May 29th, Baltimore, Maryland, Baltimore Civic Center, the adorable Adrian Adonis seeing action in Baltimore. Thursday, May 29th, Worcester, Massachusetts, the Worcester Centrum, George the Animal Steel tops the card in Worcester. Monday, May 26th, Lansing, Michigan, Lansing Civic Center, Hillbilly Jim on the bill in Lansing. Monday, May 26th, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Mecca Auditorium, Corporal Kirshner among those on the card in Milwaukee. Sunday, May 25th, Dayton, Ohio, Hara Arena, it's Tito Santana among those on the card in Dayton. It is the World Wrestling Federation. Be a part of it when it comes to your area.
My sickle butterfly.
What you say?
Have you heard the news?
No, tell me about it.
I've got the blue.
Deliver.
The Levi's 501 blue.
They shrink the fit.
That's it in there, right beside.
Do tell.
My personal life. The Levi's 501 blue.
Lucky fly.
Ain't I?
My
mind. Yeah, I like that. I like that.
No matter where you are, with bum rustlers, it's just like being in a wrestling ring. With Hulk Hogan and Rowdy Roddy Piper.
One, two, three, pin!
Wherever you are, it's like real wrestling action. With Junkyard Dog and Volkoff. Bum rustle anywhere with Hulk and the Iron Sheik.
Attention, back to class.
Wrestle anywhere with wrestling superstars, bum rustlers, new from LJN.
Now, you can share the sound of your pocket stereo with all your friends using the all-new SoundOff speaker system. Simply snap the speaker on your cassette player and turn it into a versatile sound system. The new SoundOff easily fits all speakerless pocket radios and tape players. Take off the earphones and enjoy the music anywhere. At work, at play, at home, or away. Lightweight, sturdy, and durable, they snap on or off in a second and make any portable a stereo sound system for just $12.95. Use your credit card or mail check or money order, and you'll also receive this stereo headset. A $10 value, it's yours free. So order now. Get stereo speakers plus the free headset, a super value, just $12.95.
To order the Sound Off speakers and get your free stereo headset, credit card customers call toll-free 1-800-922-5100. That's 1-800-922-5100. Or send $12.95 plus $2 postage and handling to Sound Off, P.O. Box 7000-51, Amherst, New York.
This tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my right, the distinguished manager, Mr. Fuji. And the tag team combination from parts unknown at 277 pounds, Moondog Spot. His partner from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 267 pounds, the magnificent Morocco. Their opponents from Scotland, weighing 228 pounds, Scott McGee. His partner from Tampa, Florida, at 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Wow, what a tremendous tag team combination we have here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Of course, only the best being brought to you through the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation. And Morocco, before this match got underway, looked over and said, I'm going to dedicate a pile driver to you, Adrian.
Did he? You know, Reese
is here. In fact, he better watch it. He's not on the receiving end of one himself.
I don't think it'll happen. You have to admit that Paul Orndorff is a super athlete, but also a spoiled athlete. Scott McGee's got the potential, but he still needs the experience, and he's going to get it with Don Morocco.
So you think that Mr. Wonderful is a spoiled athlete?
I think he is, and I know he is. Look at the magnificent run. He is strutting, he is talking, he is walking. He does exactly what he wants in that ring. You know, we're good friends, you know. We used to share an apartment.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Well, how interesting things become as we go through the realm of realism here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, you would pick up things if you quit reading the Inquirer.
Look at this. Over the top, Morocco down in front. Goes Mr. Wonderful, nice arm drag, caught him coming in, and another one. Morocco got outsmarted.
I don't think so. Look at how fast he went up to his feet. And the referee is on the ball, too.
Right in there. Make sure the right guy stays in and the wrong guy gets out. That's most important. Look at Fuji with that cane. Talk about distraction.
He is a vicious human being in his own right, too, you know. You ever hear him laugh? It sounds like somebody's putting thumb screws at him. They're just tightening and tightening. It's hard. It's vicious.
Mr. Wonderful on the receiving end. Look at this. Scotty didn't want to waste any more time. He saw Mr. Wonderful get the number done on him, so he came in immediately, and now all four men in the ring.
Well, obviously, the referee has lost it right now, but what are you going to do with the magnificent one and Paul Orndorff in that ring?
Look at this. Wow, they were thrown off at the last moment.
And outsmarted.
Scotty McGee really took the brunt of that blow.
You can tell that Morocco's the general in that ring right now.
Look out. Both men double teamed to the corner. Oh, look at this. Mr. Wonderful using his partner to good advantage. And still all four men in the ring. Pandemonium broken loose here this week.
You think as good as he said, you couldn't have done that by yourself.
Well, two against two makes it fair.
Mm-hmm.
Look at Spotty. He's not too happy about what's happening. And neither is Mr. Fuji for that matter. Talk about your tremendous tag team competition. We certainly have it with us this week. I'd like to see this in a single matchup right here.
It would be something, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
I bet you a magnificent one would want it too.
With possibly you as the guest referee.
Oh, wouldn't that be something?
Yeah. Orndorff got out of there. Young Scotty McGee tagged in, and now Spotty's tagged in. Spotty and Scotty going to have trouble keeping them apart now.
Oh, you're a poet. You don't know it.
Yes. Oh, look at that backbreaker. Bulldog Spot can do that as well as anyone. Look out below. Wow.
Got the shoulder.
Morocco says, let me have him. And Morocco, so deliberate in every one of his moves, he doesn't waste any energy.
No. That's a professional and a champion, such as himself.
Former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion.
Yes. Two times, I believe.
Took the title away from Pat Patterson.
Pat Patterson?
Yes. Pedro Morales.
Yeah, Madison Square Garden.
Madison Square Garden. Pat Patterson was the first one to hold the coveted title. Won it in Rio de Janeiro, South America.
Did he really?
Yeah.
That's the red one.
Scotty, not faring too well right now. This is the time to get over and make the tag. That's what tag team wrestling is all about.
He's paying his dues, too.
Oh, look at that clothesline.
The kid is tough. The kid is tough, I have to admit. He is tough.
He's a comer.
Good looking, too.
Oh. There it is. There's a tag made. Mr. Wonderful off the top rope with an elbow. A big right hand. And one for the Moondog. He's on fire. Morocco is stuck.
Morocco's got a plan.
Oh, nice reversal. Watch out. Oh, look at that.
Neckbreaker. Come on, Donald. Donald, get up, Donald.
Morocco, Donald out of it.
Oh, look at these idiots screaming for no reason at all.
Here comes the pile driver. He's trying to get him up. Now here comes Spotty. And look at Mr. Fuji. He was about to climb in there.
I think he was a decoy.
Morocco was in deep trouble there, about to have the pile driver applied to him.
Almost only.
Wow. What a clothesline. Two count. He got him.
I guess it's a lucky day.
Obviously, he caught Moondog's spot right on the magic button as he knocked him right down and out. And look at this. Morocco, not too happy. It'll go down in the record books as a loss. Let's get your
three winners of this bout, Scott McGee and Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, that means the loser, Bob Morocco.
No.
Yes. Let's go back and take a look at how Mr. Wonderful polished off Spotty. Things going his way right here, eh? But watch how quick the tables can turn.
Yes,
look at this out of nowhere. Oh, right on a butt. Down for the easy 1-2-3 count. And look at Scotty coming in to make sure that Morocco doesn't interfere. Don't go away, wrestling fans. An interview coming up.
Again, wrestling fans, as you've come to expect, the finest in professional wrestling today from the World Wrestling Federation. But now, ladies and gentlemen, these past 2 weeks, talk out throughout the world of professional wrestling. The event that occurred on Saturday night, main event, a bout between Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake the Snake, your entire
career.
I was shocked would be a better word. First off.
And you don't know me very well if you were surprised, because I'll tell you something. People that know me know that I'll take that extra step. You know, I'm the kind of man that if he's going to rob a bank, I wouldn't walk in the front door of a man. I'd come right in the back. Nobody's there. That's the kind of man I am.
Jake Roberts, how can you be proud of attacking a man from behind before the bout even started?
Bottom line, I walked out, he didn't. It's no game to me.
Bottom line, the national audience heard, you did not get a victory. The decision upheld due to the events that you yourself precipitated. And then administer the DDT, a hole that I've never seen any man walk away from, but to do it to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat on the concrete floor.
That was a first for me. It's the first time I've ever dropped anybody on the concrete. Now, I'll tell you something. I'm a little bit shocked to see Steamboat walking around. I'm a real surprised man right now, but I know that Steamboat has to be thinking one thing. Your whole career was almost over in a split second.
Perhaps, Jake Roberts, that tells you a little bit of what the Dragon is made out of.
It tells me that he's a fool. That's what it tells me, Ken. Any man that would reach out and get bit once and come back to face the same type of poison has got to be a fool. Steamboat, don't you understand? I don't play the game. I don't watch the game. The DDT and I, we rule the game, my man.
Speaking of getting bit, after all you did, as if to add insult to injury, how could you pull that snake out and wrap it around the prone body of the steamer?
Well, everybody knows me, that I always had the devil walking next to me, and that's the deal that I made. It's a thing in my life that I've done. So yes, whenever I drop somebody with the DDT, I do take Damien out, because I think once I've had the man, I should share him with Damien. Intimidation is the key to my success. You think about that.
Wrestling fans, Jake the Snake Roberts, you all saw his actions on Saturday Night Main Event. But you fans know, even Jake Roberts admitted he's surprised to see Ricky the Dragon Steamboat up and around. It tells you what the Steamboat is made out of, and rest assured, Jake the Snake Roberts has not heard the end from Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. That you can put in the bank.
Do you think she's wearing one of the world's most sensuous fragrances, Giorgio of Beverly Hills? But what she's really wearing is a similar seductive fragrance called Our Secret. 1 ounce of Giorgio perfume costs $150. 1 ounce of Our Secret perfume costs $19.95.
Our Secret is the best copy of Giorgio I have ever smelled.
I always wanted to wear Giorgio, but I just couldn't afford it.
If you like Giorgio at $150 an ounce, we think you will love an ounce of Our Secret at only $19.95. Order right now, and we'll include a bottle of our version of Calvin Klein's Obsession perfume at no additional cost.
Now I can afford to smell expensive every day.
At $19.95 an ounce, I can almost take a bath in it.
Now, I know you're expecting me to say that the only difference between Giorgio and Our Secret is the price. But instead, I'm going to suggest that you call this toll-free number to order, and you find out for yourself. Test Giorgio perfume at your local department store. Compare its fragrance with that of Our Secret. If you're not completely delighted for any reason whatsoever, simply return the Our Secret bottle, even if it's empty, even if you've used all the perfume. And your full purchase price of $19.95 will be refunded. However, keep the copy of Obsession as our free gift to you. And if someone asks how you can afford to smell so good, don't tell them. Let it be Our Secret.
To order, call 1-800-228-2222. Save COD charges by using your credit card. Or send $19.95 plus $3 shipping to Perfume Box 1313, Burbank, California. But for fastest action, call 1-800-228-2222. Remember, our version of Obsession is yours free. So call 1-800-228-2222.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. Dentine chewing gums. While you're chewing Dentine, it freshens your breath as effectively as even mouthwash. Brush your breath with Dentine.
Feels so good. Coming down. Coming down.
This nerd is in for a blast, a frosty, refreshing Banaca blast. The blast you'll lose your head over.
Is this yours?
The Banaca Blast.
It's plumbing.
For hair clogs at their worst.
Oh, it's for you.
Liquid Plumber is the plumber to call first.
We've got the Viewmaster out. A lot of things happening here in the World Wrestling Federation. Of course, the Superstars dolls are still available on the market. I understand that there will be a Mean Gene doll out here in short order. And the Bendies are out on the market. Next week, we're going to be back here with more exciting All-American Wrestling. You're going to be seeing Tony Atlas and Leaf and Lanny Poffo team up in tag team action. In the Flower Shop, a new addition to the World Wrestling Federation, guests of Adrian Adonis and Jimmy Mouth of the South Heart, Handsome Harley Race will be here. And oh, what a feature bout. British Bulldogs, current tag team champions, to meet Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy. All of that and a whole lot more next week, back here on All American Wrestling. Gene Okerlund saying, having a good week, and so long, everybody.
Don't wrestle with how to fill your sports appetite. Tune into the Italian Open, men's Grand Prix tennis. Semi-final action tonight at 10. Now stay tuned for Kung Fu Theater, next on USA.